is Wednesday, November 19th. Over half of the continental U.S. has snow on the ground, and more could be on the way. I'm Tori King.
And I'm Colton D. The state of Michigan says don't bring your shrimp here. We'll tell you what that means. Your CSN News starts now.
Snowstorms and record low temperatures whacked much of the country this week, and there's more havoc coming on Wednesday. About 50% of the country has had snow on the ground since Tuesday. According to the National Weather Service, Buffalo, New York, one of the hardest hit areas is buried under 6 feet of snow and counting. Another blast of cold air will hammer the northwest, northeast on Wednesday, while the southeast could see record lows as temperatures drop into the 20s and teens. Around here, watch out for morning fog and maybe some snow showers tomorrow night.
A bill to approve the Keystone Extra Large Oil Pipeline failed in the Senate on Tuesday by just one vote. The bill failed on a 59-41 vote. It needed 60 to pass, with pipeline backers falling short and the project still stuck in a State Department review process. Republicans already voted to bring up the legislation in the next session when they have complete control of Congress.
Killer shrimp, red swamp, crayfish, and five other water-dwelling animals are officially banned from Michigan for threatening the balance of life in local lakes. The prohibited invasive species are illegal to possess if they are alive, as there is concerning that they will hurt existing in the aquatic populations of the food chain. The other killer shrimp, for example, is an aggressive inch-long crustacean that eats invertebrates its own size by literally tearing them into pieces with its large claws. Michigan has planned on banning the seven species since 2013. The official decision came last week during a meeting of National Resource Commission. The ban on invasive species is about awareness as well as laws. People are particularly like anglers are the first to see anything suspicious. We'll be right back after these messages.
Thanksgiving is coming up, and good food is the best part. But with the holiday season comes the stress of cooking. If you want to take it easy in the kitchen this Thanksgiving, stop by the English Honor Society Bake Sale between the 17th and the 21st. The English Honor Society Bake Sale will be running the week before Thanksgiving during all three lunches. At this bake sale, you can get a homemade apple or pumpkin pie before you go on break on the 24th. You do not want to pass up on this opportunity. Stop by the English Honor Society Bake Sale and pick up your fresh homemade apple or pumpkin pie today.
Today's weather is brought to you by Dr. Kim Keller. Your smile is your first impression. Make it a good one and visit Dr. Keller today. Today's high of 35 with a low of 25. Tomorrow's high with 38 and a low of 25.
Have you brought your 2015 yearbook yet? The deadline to purchase is January 16th and they are $70. You will need to put half down to reserve a book and pay the other half later. Make your payment at the front office on December 4th and 5th. During all three lunches, the yearbook staff will be collecting money and promoting this yearbook's amazing book. Pay now and you will be guaranteed a yearbook when they come in May. Also, remember, personalized senior yearbook ads are due and payable by December 5th.
The Nampa football banquet will be tomorrow at 6 p.m. in the cafeteria. All players need to bring a dessert. Dinner will be provided.
The library staff is putting together a bulletin board entitled, What I Am Thankful For. Come by the library and write down what you are thankful for on a leaf before the end of the day.
The Salvation Army Angel Tree is now set up in the library. Individuals and groups are encouraged to share the magic of Christmas with a needy child by providing a toy. Select a tag from the tree and bring your unwrapped gift back to the library.
Like to ski or snowboard? Want to learn how? Come to the snow team meeting tomorrow at 2:45 in room 102. See Miss Rutherford with any questions. Also, Sports Med Club members, your next meeting is today. Athletic training room at 2:45. Remember to bring your fundraising ideas.
Today's SAT word of the day is forestall, a verb that means to take beforehand, to anticipate, to hinder, or prevent by measures taken in advance.
You could use it this way. After Carl has served each of the children their a loaded cookie. He hid the bag away to forestall efforts by the kids to get him to give them more.
That's your news. We'll see you again tomorrow, right here on the Bulldog Edition.